On the run from a wild pack of wolves or an angry East Coast mafia? Neither one sounds like a particularly desirable situation, but they do make for great movies. This is Movie Night. Hello and welcome to Movie Night, YouTube's weekly interactive movie review show. I'm your host, Jonathan Paula. On tonight's program, we'll be taking a look at two critically acclaimed films, the first of which is currently playing nationwide in theaters, The Grey. Released just 1 week ago on January 27th, this Alaskan survival thriller starring Liam Neeson has already recouped its $25 million budget. And for good reason, it is a splendidly exciting and entertaining motion picture. Neeson is part of a ragtag group of social outcasts, ex-cons, deadbeats, and lowlifes, who drill for oil in northern Alaska, all of whom crash in the middle of nowhere during their flight back to Anchorage. When only seven of the men survive this plane crash, they must put aside their differences and work together, not only to stay warm in the sub-zero temperature, but also to fend off a vicious pack of wolves that are hunting them from a nearby den.
Hey, what is that?
Run!
Go! Go!
Get into the tree!
Go, go, go!
Oh, Jesus, they're right on us!
Don't look back!
Don't stop! You see him?
They're all around us!
Need a fire to keep them off us.
What transpires over the 117-minute film isn't particularly new or original, but some twists and turns make it worth experiencing unspoiled. The busiest man in Hollywood right now in his first of six films for 2012, Liam Neeson is absolutely terrific in the lead role, easily showcasing one of his strongest performances in years. A monologue where he is shouting to the heavens demanding that God prove his existence is an emotionally gripping and powerful one. Most of the characters are developed only well enough to move the plot forward, but a late-act scene where Neeson laments over not knowing his fallen comrades better makes up for this setback. This traditional story is framed by beautiful cinematography, which despite most of the film taking place during a blizzard, expertly captures the majesty and danger of the Alaskan wilderness. A somber soundtrack and clever use of diegetic audio drives the amazingly suspenseful action sequences, which are some of the tensest I've seen in years. But the serious and sometimes playful scenes between them is what gives this man-against-beast adventure a lot of its heart. A post-credit shot will have you questioning the interesting ending, so make sure to stay tuned for it. At times terrifying and yet still undeniably captivating, The Grey is an exhilarating, nail-biting adventure thriller. Well, those are my thoughts. Now let's see what you had to say in the YouTube comments. Here's a Rate-O-Matic to show us our scores for The Grey. A double 9. Being only a week old, not many of you have had a chance to see this film yet, and those that did disagreed on how good it actually is. But you did agree it is a thrilling and exciting motion picture. Your scores average to an awesome. I hesitate to give this movie a full 10, but honestly, there was hardly anything here I didn't like. I thought it excelled in the pacing and emotional impact areas, while struggling a bit in the believability and story departments. I gave it an awesome as well. Our second film tonight is Drive. Premiering at the 2011 Cannes Film Festival to a standing ovation, this brooding drama starring Ryan Gosling was released nationwide on September 16th, where it quickly earned over four times its $15 million budget. Foolishly misadvertised as a fast-paced action thriller, Drive is anything but. The 100-minute film requires absolute patience and an open mind to truly be appreciated. Developing slowly, with almost painfully long sequences without dialogue, Gosling's soft-spoken character is a professional stunt driver slash mechanic who moonlights as a criminal getaway driver for hire.
Looks like we have a bigger problem than I thought. We're gonna have to keep the car here for a few days. So I offered your services to take Benicio and Irene home. That be okay?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Hey, do you wanna see something?
Yeah.
Okay.
After falling for his quiet and fragile next-door neighbor played by Carey Mulligan, the unnamed driver gets himself mixed up in a pawn heist gone wrong, and now Albert Brooks and the rest of the mafia is out for his blood. Between the astonishingly beautiful cinematography that just oozes off the screen and the magical love story at its center, Drive is littered with quick punches of gory violence and intense chase sequences. Unapologetic with its delivery, this movie transports the viewer into Driver's underworld through magnificent use of sight and sound. The electric pop soundtrack here is one for the ages, and unquestionably makes the film worth watching. A smart movie, with even smarter writing, Drive never once slows itself down for unneeded exposition, instead trudging forward with its pitch-perfect performances from the entire cast, which also includes Bryan Cranston, Ron Perlman, and Christina Hendricks. Despite receiving just one Oscar nomination, the high critical praise for Drive is rightly deserved. This is a fresh, different, and brazenly powerful film that throws convention to the wind in favor of an immensely stylistic approach to storytelling. While I can appreciate the artistic merit here, there is decidedly something missing to really keep my attention focused on a film that, although never reaches actual levels of boredom, really pushes the boundaries in the pacing department, sometimes with terrific results, and other times leaving me wanting more. Drive. Slow and shameless. Fantastically beautiful. Well, that's my review. Now let's read some of yours from the YouTube comments. The Rate-O-Matic again to show us our scores for Drive, an 8 and a 9. Although there were some dissenting opinions amongst you, the majority of you loved and appreciated this film for the magnificent work of art that it is. You thought it was awesome, and I almost agreed. While it wasn't too slow that I didn't like it, there was something missing from Drive. Extra character development, perhaps. I can't quite put my finger on it. But this is maybe a film that will reward repeat viewings. Until now, though, I thought it was a very solid great. That does it for tonight's films, so now let's see what's currently playing in theaters with some tweet critiques. Remember, if you're going to the movies this weekend, make sure to submit your Twitter review using the JPMN hashtag to have it featured on an upcoming episode. Next week, we'll be taking a look at two new DVD releases, the first of which is In Time, an exciting original sci-fi thriller starring Justin Timberlake, and The Big Year, a big-budget comedy film starring Steve Martin that miserably bombed at the box office last fall. As always, I encourage you to buy, rent, or download these films, and let me know what you think about them by voting in the polls below or by leaving me a comment review. Once again, my name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching Movie Night. I hope to see you right back here next Friday.